Hello, my name is Denis. I'm TTC Volga Telecom operator. It will be a lightning talk. I would like to thank the organizers of the conference for the participation. I am a participant of the program UNOC Fellowship, and we are a subsidiary of Transtelecom, and our scope of is the Lower Poволжье in Russia, and I will update you on the deployment of IPv6 in our region. The first thing I will start from is getting off IPv6 addresses. Since we are LIR, we sent a request to RIPNCC for the assignment of this block, and we were asked how many we need, /29 or 32, and I decided to take 32 for the next generation to be grateful when IP addresses will start to see. Since we have three regions in the coverage, I thought that /32 network will be enough. So we still have a reserve. Then I created the relevant objects in the network, and then I had to set up the relevant support in our routers and servers. You have to be very careful when you update IPv6 sessions between the route reflectors and the router, because some models of the routers, they can update the special session. Please take this into account, since there can be rerouting of the traffic, which can disaggregate the service for the clients, for the customers. The next step is to increase the uplinks and all other stuff, the setting of IPv6 on the servers, to make sure the DNS has the connectivity with IPv6 and the customers can send their queries through the IPv6. The most interesting thing for us is the massive deployment of IPv6 for home users. It was quite scary to allocate all these IPv6 addresses to all the clients, but I believe that only those devices will receive it that really can operate with IPv6. But I took this risk, and we use only native IPv6, and the customers have DOSTIC inside VVP, and over 1.5 years of this network, we do not have a query or application from the customers that will have some, which will face some problems in the internet because IPv6. The pattern of the service is provided. When there is the connection to our network, two methods are used: stateful configuration, when IPv6 competitive router is used, and the size of the prefix is /56. And currently, there is a reserve for the future rather than the real need. It's better to provide for more addresses rather than to change the address plan in some time. And the second option is to stable configuration with the direct connection to the network. IPv6 addresses will be allocated, and the client will operate on dual stack. The analysis of this mass deployment of IPv6 shows in this slide you have three graphs. The upper one, this is the uplink graph. Through these links with white IP addresses enter it. The mid graph, this is the routing graph, which processes above 4, not 4. And the clients with gray IP addresses enter this. Some of our clients work with white, and the other part with gray IP V4 addresses, and those that are lucky to get IPv6 addresses, they use dual stack. The lower graph, this is the clean traffic on uplink. Let's evaluate the share of IPv6 traffic to the general traffic, to the total traffic. Let's take any particular day. It is in September 2017. The peak IPv6 is 20 p.m., 8 p.m., and the amount of traffic for both the graphs was about 11 gigabits per second, and IPv6 was 40 megabits per second. And accordingly, we divided this, and we get 3.6%, that is the share of the traffic on IPv6 of the total traffic. When the contact share, the contact now it switched off. The contactor, contactor in the Russian is the most popular social network, and the traffic, IPv6 traffic is very slow, is relatively slow. Now, customers. This slide shows the findings of some teams, the total number of users and the utilization of two pools. The first one, this is the pool of addresses allocated to the personal computers with the direct connection to the web and to WAM ports through VSMP protocols. For each connection, it is /64. The second slash, that is a part of addresses allocated through another protocol to the IPv6 routers. Every connection, the consumption is /56. And in general, in the evening time, it is about 4.6% of clients that work stateless, and in daytime, it is about 5%. And these stateless customers account for over 0.75% of our clients. This is a very small number. Thank you. Thanks to the home routers that do not support IPv6. The next thing, let's evaluate the share of traffic in those customers that use dual stack. We found it out from the previous slate that we have 8.6% of such clients. Let's calculate its IPv4 traffic, and we will get 946 megabits per second. IPv6 traffic of such clients in the peak hours from the previous slide is 400 megabits per second. And the share of the IPv6 traffic against the dual stack is 30%. This is the approximate estimation, I believe. This 30% share is quite a nice value. And if all the customers had IPv6 addresses, then the IPv6 traffic on uplink will be about 30% of the total traffic. This slide shows two graphs during the launch of the IPv6 in Wi-Fi network in one of the hotels in 2015. The upper graph, this is the total traffic for the hotel, and the lower one, this is IPv6 traffic. And we believe that the hotel, most of the devices of these, they support IPv6, and the graphs in different monitoring system, therefore the scale does not coincide, but you can see it with your eye that at different time periods, there is about 20-30% of the traffic. IPv6 accounts for these 20-30% of the traffic. And the last slide is those preventing factors that prevent deployment of IPv6. Actually, these factors are multi-stamp, but the most important of them is that most home routers still do not support IPv6, and this is the major challenge in our network, the so-called limiting factor. The second one is poor understanding of the management of the need of the introduction and deployment of IPv6, the lack of the need from the businesses in IPv6, the non-desire of the administrators to be trained in these new technologies, or the fear to lose time or to drop the network. And the overall crisis of networking in Russia. And IPv6 providers are just volunteers, enthusiasm, and they are enthusiastic guys that simply believe in this technology and try to promote it. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, you are welcome. Thank you. This is what we lack, by the way. We have three. Great. Three questions. You are welcome.
It's okay.
It doesn't work. Oh, okay. It works. Hello, my name is Jan George, Internet Society. I was wondering, technical question. First of all, congratulations. Thank you for this very nice presentation and for all your energy to make a good case for deployment of IPv6. But my question is, you said on the one side of the CPE, you just give link locals and 1/128. What exactly do you do there, and why you don't go for /127 or for 400/64 for the connectivity link.
Я так понял, вот этот слайд, this slide.
I understand you mean this slide. Our clients are connected through PPT PPUE technology. For IPv6 it's /128 and 132/132. But prefix delegation 164? No, it is consumed for one interface. In reality, it's 128, but the reserve is 164 and /56.
Okay, so in this case, just the CPE. This is sort of like a local address for the CPE then.
PPUE interface uses /128, but on the brass side, it thinks it's /64.
Okay, yeah.
So
thank
it
you.
Wastes all of it.
No. That's a good way of doing things.
But it's okay.
We reserve 1/64. That's a common.
Yeah, each client consumes /64 on the brass side.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Please.
Hello, my name is Natalie Trenneman. I work for RIPE NCC as IPv6 program manager and trainer. One of the questions we always get in our IPv6 training course. And I'm going to ask the same question to you, since you did it. Is it expensive? What was the most expensive part of your IPv6 deployment?
Самая дорогая часть вашего внедрения V6.
Спасибо.
Thank you for your question. What was the question, by the way? The most extensive part of IPv6 deployment. Where is this sense? What was the most expensive thing in terms of the costs, expenses, or time? Only the personal time. It was extra work time. Because it was purely enthusiastic stuff. In order to be invited to ENOC meeting. I will never start deployment of IPv6.
Thank you, Natalie.
Спасибо. Артём Горяченков.
Артём Горяченков. Thank you very much. That was an ideal lightning talk. I have one question. After the deployment of IPv6, did you see any changes in the number of units opened, number of tickets opened from the clients, and if yes, to which extent? No, it didn't change. No changes. The percentage is small. So it didn't get more or less, no changes. Thank you. Can you show the statistics which you have for both sessions? Can you come back to that slide once again? The previous one. Yes, this one. I see. So your limits are not over yet. Our limit is 65,000. I wish you to reach this limit. We have quite a good reserve for the future. Thank you. Using this opportunity, I would like to give my best regards to Saratov. I know that they are watching me in TTK Volga. My regards to you. I'm fine. I will come back quite soon. And we will continue our inventory. Thank you.